they're bickering about, has anyone tweeted their DVD release? It's like McCartney and Lennon of comedy seeing all this.
I'll tweet whatever you want me to tweet. Just tell me what you want me to tweet and I'll tweet it.
Who's that?
That's my impression.
Oh, sorry, I didn't realise. Sorry. It's very powerful. It's very powerful.
That's George Harrison, quite clearly, from the Let It Be.
John Coleshaw, better watch
George
out.
George Harrison, of course it is. Yes, it's
this is a terrible start. Can we just do this again?
Luckily, it's not live.
Our special guests this morning are Armstrong and Miller, two of the nicest people in this industry. You both are such decent, posh people. Very well managed. You're immaculate. They're always well presented. There's no turning up in a T-shirt or anything like that. You both of you, you look very well this morning. Presentable. Thank you very much for coming in.
Well, extremely well. Lovely to see you.
Yeah.
It's nice to be here.
Yeah. And now big megastars as well. BBC One on Friday nights. That's got to feel good.
It's great. It's been a joy, hasn't it, sir?
It has. It's been a fantastic, fantastic run. And because of the needy children last Friday,
Yeah.
We've had a little week's break.
You've had a little night off.
Friday night off.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice for you both.
That's good.
So listen, you, suddenly, like the last couple of years, and then now your big deal back doing what you do really well. The sketches are fantastic. The characters are great as well. The RAF men, it's my highlight of that show. That just works, doesn't it? Week in, week out.
It's a joy. That is a fantastic writer, Simon Blackwell, who writes those.
Oh, right. A guy from the thick of it. And,
yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Amazing, right? I mean, those just sort of fall through the letterbox on a Monday.
Do you know straight away when you've got a real, this is it, this would be a really good one, or is it you never know, organically they grow, some work, some don't?
You sort of know-ish. Sometimes you think there's something in there and it hasn't quite landed properly. Yeah. But we try everything out with a live audience.
Do you?
Yeah, we take
a little
pub theatre in Islington and we'll run through
it. We say
everything.
Brave, I mean, a pub at first, I was thinking like a Yeats's Wine Lodge, and then when you say it's a pub in Islington,
Islington.
I mean, how bad is the heckling going to get there, you know? Some balsamic vinegar being trucked you guys or something.
Throwing hummus.
We got drizzled.
Shockingly drizzled.
Yeah.
And so now, you know, it's BBC One. Are they looking after you?
Yeah, yes. They really are. Yeah,
they're
they really
lovely.
Are.
No,
they're
great. This is how well they're looking after us. They've given us another series.
You're all down right. They should be.
They've given
get out
us
of
a
here.
Third.
Mitchell and Webb can't do it all, can they, boys? Huh?
Yeah.
They do most of it, but they can't do it all.
It's not been all of it. I've seen the adverts in the papers, right, for the tour, right?
Yeah.
Huge venue, selling out really well. So I said to Richie, they must be either starting it or halfway through. Can you just find out before they come? And he goes, it's 2010.
It's this time next year. We will be literally this time next year.
What's going on with the tour?
We're gearing up. It's a monster. I mean,
so why aren't you on tour now?
Well,
I mean, I'm not your agent, boys, but it's the time to cash in when you're on the TV. I mean, obviously you're going to be there next year, but... Mm.
That is true. Although at the moment, we're writing our next series. Because the problem was, I think, not a problem, but the way it worked out was it was 2 years between this series and the one before. So we want to get the next one out a little bit quicker.
Well, you're like the Stone Roses with your kind of work rate here, aren't you? 2 years on, 1 year off. What's going on, you two? You're bust into a sweat.
We are going to work so hard on this tour. It's going to be a massive theatrical extravaganza. Don't ask me what's going to be in it yet. It's 2010, it's fine.
It's a Soleil experience.
No, that's exactly what it's going to be. It's going to be, we are in the process of negotiating with one of the finest directors of live comedy extravaganza. That's the plural.
Lloyd Webber we're talking about here.
We are in negotiation and it's going to be a theatrical spectacular. That's all I can promise.
So since I've seen you, you've gotten married, and now you've got two little kids as well, and a five-month-old who's teething.
That's right. Yeah.
No wonder you want to book in that tour next year.
Oh, yeah.
You're a smart dad.
No. He's coming with us. I haven't told you. Right.
Your wife's insisted.
Yes.
Is the family coming on tour?
No, just the boys.
Just the boys.
Brilliant.
Actually, I was joking. Now I think about that. We could have
will hear this, and she'll be going, yes, you're quite right, Zana, that will be happening. MTV Cribs, literally.
Wouldn't that be brilliant? We could have a little
I've given you an idea now for the show, MTV Cribs.
Could work.
Yeah, that could work.
And you're still keeping an eye out on the CERN project. Haven't they lost the Higgs boson?
Did you not follow the news this weekend?
Have they found
exciting.
It now?
She's back.
No, no, they've got the they've had two beams going around the LHC this weekend. It's so exciting. Yes. Yeah, yeah. You know, they've had a kind of below the you know a kind of low key startup. They got and full insertion was achieved over the weekend.
Well, that's enough about your Friday night.
So I wasn't talking about CERN. No, no. It's just my excitement at the. At the success of the
experiment. Because remember this, you have a degree in, is it solid physical matter?
Solid physical matter. I mean, I suppose you could call it solid state physics. Yeah, I've got a degree in physics, and I did a PhD in solid state physics. That's absolutely right. Yeah,
thank
yeah.
you.
That's unusually, people usually say it's quantum physics, which is not really... It's not really
and
the
that must be
it is
hugely
actually
irritating.
Solid. It's hugely irritating, but
oh,
you don't bother correcting
it. The paparazzi do that.
Pleased,
they ruin your life.
Very pleased to hear you say solid state physics. You don't actually know what it means.
It's because it is. It's the dark matter that binds us together. Is that right?
No.
No? What like is that?
Solid state physics is just physics that takes place in solids.
Is that all?
Yeah, yeah.
What, you, no.
sorry.
You know
the solid state. You know the solid state, as opposed to, you know, the liquid state.
It sounds like a Phil Collins album is what it sounds like to me. Solid matter or solid state. Yeah. And yeah. So to the average layperson listening right now, the Higgs boson thing, I heard they'd lost it. This is a £4 billion experiment. How could you lose it?
They didn't lose it. What happened was the magnet quenched. Basically, you've got superconducting magnets that keep the electron beams on track. And what
just
happened
adding
was
production to all bring it live for radio.
What happened was they overheated and caused.
Listen, you can't have a £4 billion experiment and overheating's a problem.
Yes, you can. You
that
can.
Was to an old Morris miner, not
this
the
isn't...
CERN project.
No, but this is something we've never done before. This is the absolute forefront of human knowledge. You can't expect. It's not like sort of wiring up an AM radio. I mean, this is like something that nobody has ever done before, and people aren't even sure if it's possible. So, of course, it's going to be slightly tricky. You know, it's not going to be. You know, it's not like a chemistry 2 set that you're sort of just reassembling.
He's tearing into me now. I've really gone down, haven't you? Ben's not really happy with me now about this whole hadron collider thing. I think it was a mistake in the interview was the whole hadron collider element. But what's the point? Well, how will we benefit?
How will we benefit?
If they do whatever they need to do.
Quite like this. Absolutely like this.
Are we going to get jetpacks?
We get jetpacks if we understand... Well, we get jetpacks if we understand the laws of physics. And the moment we don't understand what gives things mass. So once we find the Higgs boson, we have a mechanism for understanding how objects have mass. And that's really, really important. We need to know why we get mass.
Yeah, and once we have...
You're happy to go through your life without knowing how we've got mass?
I've got through life... Not knowing how to say Higgs boson. I've just learned. We've all learned something there, haven't we?
And so once we learn how we have mass, how will that improve our day-to-day existence, though?
Well, I mean...
There we go.
That's like saying, well, now why should I bother to develop language? How's that actually going to help me? I mean, these things are so fundamental. You know, they are the foundation of all knowledge. So
there are people in pubs right now going, when are we going to find out about physics and mass?
Put it this way, everything in this room, you're broadcasting on the radio, everything is a consequence of quantum physics. And that's a really, really weird theory that no one particularly wanted to believe at the beginning of the, you know, the 1900s when it was first proposed. That's produced everything that we've got today. So the more we know about quantum physics... Pop-Tarts. Yeah, absolutely.
Pop-Tarts.
Because the chip in your toaster wouldn't be able to produce a Pop-Tart if we didn't have quantum physics. And the more quantum physics we understand, the more we increase the potential of other technology in the future.
I think there's a character in the next series of your show. The crazed physicist.
Ben Miller.
He's got it.
Yeah, he's already in it.
Let's bring it round to a more traditional interview now. I feel that we've gone down somewhere.
Yeah.
The DVD is out today. I think we're on safer ground.
Yeah,
there.
Yeah, we
keep it kind of Parkinson light.
Good. It comes out today. Not just the DVD of the series just gone or still going, but a box set as well of last series too. So you've got series 1 and 2 available, should you want it.
Ooh. And extras, because everyone wants the extras.
Plenty.
These days. Yeah.
Plenty
deleted scenes.
There's, deleted scenes like you wouldn't believe. We've filmed a lot more than we needed for this last series. Yeah. And there's a series called The Node.
A lot more than anyone else needed.
Mainly the BBC.
As it turns out, yes. But
look, Zana's trying to do the selling bit.
No,
you
no,
can't
yes,
undermine
no, no.
it, Ben.
It's good. No, it's good. It's good. It's good.
We've got a series called The Node, which is online. And I think we put those onto the extras as well. There's a lot of chat from Ben and me.
And you're doing the commentaries as well, because people really like this DVD commentaries now.
I'd love to do a commentary, but I don't think on a sketch show. Do you think that would work? I don't know.
Could do.
Yeah, I'd love to do a commentary. I've never done a commentary. I've never done a commentary on. You know, when you sort of I'm here with the
director of this sketch here, the costume designer of our wigs. And also, the other week, many years ago, on the last radio session for XFM, we used to play Gay Bar, Want to Tell, and I haven't heard it for years. And I'm watching your show 2 or 3 weeks ago, it crops back up in the most horrendous situation, the wigs and stuff like that. You managed to put that into a, what was an Edwardian setting and then violence at the end of it. Brilliant.
Yeah. I want to take, that was very
you,
good.
Sir.
That's actually Zander playing the piano as well.
My wife said, because I was just thinking, crikey, I haven't heard this song in ages. And then my wife said, is he actually playing the piano as well?
I was playing the piano. And moderately.
How do you hold the sheet music to that, Gay Bar?
Hey, no, I had to work it out myself. I had to listen to it. You go, all right. It was a very painstaking couple of minutes. Committing that one, didn't I?
And you've got your own website as well. You now have, I mean, you two have been going for a few years now. Yeah. Why no website?
I know. It's hopeless.
Saga Holidays have been online longer than you guys. Wogan's been, you know, on the net longer than. Why only today?
It is exciting. Armstrongandmiller.co.uk.
Armstrong and Miller. And you have to spell the and out. You have to spell it.
Forcing our way through into the cyber age, aren't we?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, what's happened to the .com?
Oh, that man.
Because America's going to beckon for you boys, okay?
Yeah, well, there's
is there someone sat on it?
There's some nut job in.
Oh, that'll help him.
In Houston.
Yeah. Oh, he's selling sell it now. Yeah. Oh, that's just added another.
No, he's holding us to ransom. Also, have a look at armstrongandmiller.com and you'll see the kind of duress that we're under. Actually, somehow he thinks we're sort of multi-million-dollar.
It's going to be the next Google.
Yeah.
Forget about Twitter. When this thing breaks, it's
this
like
is
Google
going
wave.
Nuclear. Armstrongandmiller.com.
They're touring next year in September. Seriously, these guys. Yeah.
He is going to be blitzed with hits.
So what have you two, obviously the series is on for a wee bit longer.
Yep.
What have you two workaholics got coming up next, apart from the tour in September 2010?
Oh, very exciting.
We're series three. Did you just say that? Series three. Yeah, we're writing on the next series.
Yep. Yeah.
Which will be out. We're filming it next spring.
Yep.
Who Do You Think You Are?
I've just done Who Do You Think You Are.
Have you? How was that?
Yeah,
it's a good show.
I can't tell you that. I've got to keep it all a secret till.
Is it? You seem quite happy about it, because a lot of them, when it can be a journey into the deepest, darkest recesses of mankind.
It is, yeah.
All we need to know is, do you cry?
Is it a weeping?
I don't cry.
You don't cry.
Are you a grandson of a clown?
I know.
The tears of a clown. That's what it's called.
But
was it,
I know
was
he's
it good
gone.
Fun to do?
Amazing. Well, it's the most self-indulgent fortnight you'll ever spend, you know. Lots of people talking all about you and your family and your where you've come from, your origins.
When you break it down, it is like going through someone else's family photos. And normally, if you go and see a relative, they go, do you want to look at some of these photos for half an hour now? We've got to go. I'd love to, but...
I tell you what it's like. It's like having an endoscopic camera put up inside you, being broadcast to the nation. Because you just don't know what you're going to find. And you're sort of going, the deeper you go into yourself.
There's a DVD extra.
Yeah. Actually, there is it. There's
Inner Space.
For our box set, appropriately named.
Right, on that note, we're going to bow out on today's show. The DVD is out now. Yeah. It's a box set. You get series one and two.
Series one and two in one convenient seasonal package.
What a great voiceover there you just done as well.
Very good.
And check out the website. It's .net, is it?
.co.uk. Don't check out .com. Don't humour him. Don't give him.
You do realise he's going to get huge numbers today. We were trying this guy out. Thank you very much for coming. It's always fun. Thank you much, Sander, and Minky Miller
as well.
Pleasure.
Thank you so much.